Hey everybody, welcome back and thanks for watching Tactical Weapon Combat Ready. In this video, we're going to show you how to install the upper parts kit onto the AR-15 upper receiver. So, let's get to it. All right, so things that you are going to need, we're going to need the dust cover rod, dust cover spring, and then the dust cover C clip or clamp. That's teeny tiny, so be careful you don't lose that. Then we're going to need the forward assist spring, and then the retaining pin right here. And then, of course, the upper receiver itself. Tools you will need. You can do a couple of different things. If you're just assembling the upper receiver kit, then you can get away with using something like this, where we are just placing the receiver in right there and then putting the pins in. If you are planning on doing a complete assembly with the barrel and handguard and everything, then you would want to go with something like this. So this is my favorite. This is from VISM. And then here is just kind of a standard upper receiver vise block. And what you would do with these is you'd install it here. And then we'd take these push pins and then put them in like that. And then you'd be able to put them into your vise, which I have one over here. Okay, but right now we are just going to do the upper kit assembly. And then we will do the barrel assembly in a separate video. All right, so first thing we're going to do, we do not need any specific blocks for this. So I'm just going to do it without anything. So just the punch pins and the hammer is what we're going to be using here. Okay, so let's go and start with the dust cover first. So what we're going to be doing is we need to make sure that we are lining up these holes here. This rod is going to be going in there all the way through, but we need to get this C clamp on first. And so when we are looking at the dust cover rod, we can see that little cutout right here. That's where this is going to go. Then when you get it in, it's not lined up very well. Okay, once we get it, I may have to start this off camera. All right, so here we go, we got it on. And what this is going to do is it's going to prevent the guide rod from slipping out the back. So it would go in like this. So we have that C clamp right here, and it allows it to go all the way back, and then it'll stop right there. So it won't be able to slide through. And then once you put the barrel nut on, that's going to prevent it from sliding out this way. All right, so we have that on. Let's go ahead and get our dust cover on. Now, when we put this on, we're going to put it on like this. So the locking detent pin should be visible. We should see the whole housing. We shouldn't see this flat part. So it should be down like this. We're going to put that guide rod through, and then we're just going to put it through about halfway through this opening, and then that's where this spring comes in. And with this, I've seen some where it hasn't been loaded, but I usually load the spring. I don't know if that's the correct terminology or not, but that's just what I do. So what I'll do is I'll grab it, and then I'm going to spin it like this. So now it's got tension on it, and then I'm going to line it up on that rod and push it in and through. So here we have the small end of the spring, and then we have the long end of the spring sitting in that groove right there. So now we have that tension, and it's going to pop open. All right, now let's go ahead and do the forward assist. Now this is where it would be nice to put it in a vise block, but again, I'm not going to do that, and I'm not going to use this tool either, which this is a really nice little platform to use, but many of you may not have that, so I'm going to go ahead and start this without it. All right, so we have our retaining pin right here, and then what we want to do is we want to start to get that seated in there so it stays on its own. All right, now what we're going to do is we're going to insert the forward assist and the spring. Now with the forward assist, we want this little 50 degree notch right here. I mean, sorry, 90 degree notch. Okay, let me get this so I can point it out better. This notch right here. Okay, we want that to line up with that pin. So we have our retaining pin, then our notch right there. So we go in like this, and then that pin is going to hold the assembly in. Okay, but we want this spring in first, so let's go ahead and do that. Okay, and I'm going to make sure I have that lined up. And then we're going to depress that all the way in. And then now we go there. And sometimes when you're at this point, you may need to twist this a little bit because you may be off just a bit. Now this is where we're going to get one of these punch pins, and we are going to finish tapping it in all the way. See, so now here I'm just going to use this tool just real quick to show you. So that's where this would come in handy and be really nice if you have one. Or if you have a vise block, then you can use that as well. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to get this pin to flush almost with this thicker punch pin, and then I'm going to go to a smaller one and then finish it off. All right, and then that would do it. So we have a now completed upper receiver. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Until next time, we'll see you later.